On the outside, you see tin, cement, steel. The water stains rust, wood, the drips, puddles, the chipped away stairs, the paint on top of paint on top of paint. Taylor Field definitely shows her age, but it's been home. Maybe inexplicable, but the flaws have that charm. We're thinking of the old troughs in the washrooms bring out a chuckle in those that remember them. We smile at memories of Hemorrhoid Hill and kids running under the stands after leaping the fence of the Rider rookie section. It's a place with simple beginnings, from frozen tundra and a grandstand. It grew, the East Grandstand, lights and upper deck, AstroTurf to field turf, and it's on that turf that we watched legends grow. Ronnie and George, Elgar, Jurison, Narco, Weston, Darien. Never take me anywhere but here. It's where kids lived out their dreams. High school championships, junior football supremacy, university glory. Maybe it was simply just a touch football game where standing on the same field as those legends would make your hair stand on end to think you may have stepped in the same footsteps as your childhood heroes. There is an energy in these walls, the reverberations of thousands of feet stomping, hands banging the aluminum seats, rattling the backing behind the 100 section against the press box, the cowbells, the drum line, the pep band. Green is the color. Maybe it wasn't even football that brought you into Taylor Field Mosaic Stadium. Some met the Queen there in the 60s, the Blue Jays, WWF Wrestling. You rocked out together to the Rolling Stones, AC/DC, Bon Jovi, and Paul McCartney. A generation of those who grew up in Beatlemania singing along to Hey Jude with their kids, or maybe grandkids. There is no limit to our memories of this place. Your first game, eyes widening as you got closer, ticket in hand, walking with mom and dad. This was big time. Or maybe you were just coming home again for that Labor Day Classic, a rare home playoff game. You were proud to sit through the driving rain, snow, freezing winds. You mocked Henry and booed Wally. Who's left and who's leaving? Memory will rust and erode into list. Maybe you can tell younger generations what it was like to watch Ronnie and George play. You watched the Riders come back with two touchdowns in the final minute while others were already driving home thinking the game was done. You watched your kids' eyes light up as Gaynor drove by after another Rider touchdown. Were you there when Rocky Butler made a name for himself on Labor Day, or when the lights went out? Or 2013? Yes, 2013, where it seemed over a century-long history of more disappointment than jubilation for a franchise was wiped away in the single biggest game in Saskatchewan history. Tears have been shed before, but this time was different. People stood, thinking of all those tiny moments dotted throughout time, culminating in this one grand moment, trying to take in as much as possible for that image you'll never want to let go of. And nobody wanted to leave that night. But now it's time, isn't it? Take our last steps up those ramps and down again. Use those final beer tokens. Shuffle over to get one more butt in the cozy bench. Maybe even share the blanket with the stranger you'll high-five after that big play later. And for one final time as you walk away, look back and remember that kid who left their first game and thought those multicolored seats were cool, holding on tight to that little yellow football, who fell in love with the team, the game, the experience, who couldn't wait to come back again. And next time we do come back, it'll be a different place, for new memories, for new generations of Rider fans, and a place we'll now call home.